So you have these neurotransmitters coming into the synapse, and what happens with them? The receptors have to do with it. What happens with the neurotransmitters and the receptors?
The Zuckerman Institute is conceived of being a cross-campus, interdisciplinary neuroscience research institute, and we consider our mission to include engaging with the public and increasing people's awareness about brain and brain science. And to do that, we have a number of programs that interface with the public, and one of them is the BRAINYAC program. This is our signature program for high school students, in which we admit about 14 or more students each year to train them in neuroscience concepts. Concepts, how a lab works. We give them safety training. They learn a little bit about the campus and about science in general.
Coming into the lab, I didn't really know what to expect. Working with people older than you, more educated than you, I was a bit nervous. And then coming here and having everyone so willing to help and so cooperative, it was really eye-opening and inspiring to see like people so willing to help you out.
I never really knew what career I wanted to pursue, so when I heard about research, I wanted to like sort of explore to see if I would like it, and it turns out that I really do like it. I've been working with different proteins to see how they behave, like compared to other proteins that they already found before. So it's been cool to see something that nobody else has seen. Like, it's just research that I've been doing, and it's all new.
Research is very much an art. You know, a lot of people have a misconception about science that if you memorize a lot of facts and you organize them together well, that you'll be a good scientist, right? That's how high schools teach science. That's how schools tend to teach science. But science is an art. It's very much a creative process where you imagine how things are moving, you make a hypothesis, then you test it. And because it's such an art, it's important to have diverse opinions. So, you know, the students that we have in our lab, Cal, Idniel, I want their input. I want them to put their paint strokes on the painting, because their input into this this movement is critical.
When I first met him, he told me what his lab was about, and he did it with a drawing. And it's like you don't really expect that from a doctor, like to draw something in front of you and make it like put into terms where a kid would understand it. So it was like an experience I've really cherished.
I think it's absolutely essential for me to open up the lab. First of all, it gives me great pleasure. But second of all, because it recapitulates my own life. There was no one less likely to do science than I. I didn't know what the lab was like. A social environment, you and me interacting, talking about things, designing simple experiments that you then do with your own hands. You see the results of your own ideas. Are the ideas right? Are the ideas wrong? It's a wonderful experience. This is what I think BRAINYAC is about. I think it's to bring kids into an environment where they see the intellectual excitement, the social engagement that goes on.
You essentially see the little scientists in these students growing. At the very beginning, they think, I can't do this. I'm not smart enough. This is too hard. And many of them, by the end, actually want to stay in the lab. We try to prepare them for their summer experience from the very practical things like pipetting, making measurements, making solutions, to more theoretical things like what is a neuron.
I want to become a neurosurgeon, and BRAINYAC has just educated me about the parts of the brain, and I just know more about neurology, and it's helped me a lot.
One of the nice things about this program is it allows you know, the students to learn a lot about research, but it actually helps me because she's doing valuable work. Cheyenne was identifying the or creating three-dimensional representations of the areas of the brain that were removed by neurosurgeons. In some sense, she was doing a lot of the same kinds of things that any graduate student might actually be doing in this lab.
I think it's important to realize that the function of university makes the teaching and research inseparable. This is another generation of colleagues that we're bringing in to help the work, and as they work, they learn. Now, with the Zuckerman Mind-Brain Behavior Initiative, we're going to be in Manhattanville. We're going to be sort of opening ourselves up so we can really have a useful impact in the community and try to get young people interested in some of the most exciting scientific questions of our time.